What's going on, guys? It's Kayfield here, and I'm bringing you some iRacing action. And we are here at Texas for a 45 lap fixed race with cautions, so cautions will come out, but you guys won't see that because I'll be editing them out. Obviously nobody wants to watch cars go around slowly. I'm sure you guys are here to watch the racing. But anyway, if you don't know what iRacing is, this is the most realistic simulator out there, and it is not only for NASCAR. It's just what I've chosen iRacing primarily for is the NASCAR series. I have my A license, which is basically the highest license you can obtain besides going for Pro and DWC, which is the Drivers World Championship, and that's the elite. There's only 43 DWC drivers picked at the end of a season, which is once a year for the DWC. But otherwise, if you're an A license, you can race in any Oval Series, any car, pretty much it. But we're going to go warm up. This is the Nationwide Impala, and I am sponsored by Monster. Not really, but I just want to show you what the car looks like real quick. As you can see it in the pit, so here's my beautiful car. We can get a better shot at it, which we can do. So this is the car I'm driving. Don't mind the number. The number is given to you based on the I rating in the room. So I have the 16th highest I rating out of a full field of cars. I will be starting 7th on the grid, it looks like, with a qual time of 29.592. And that can get a lot better. That was earlier in the week when I first started running the track in the B car. I've been doing a lot of bouncing back and forth. I've been running the truck mainly this week. I think it's a lot of fun. The Gen 6, which is the Sprint Cup, I've done a few races with, but the racing is not as exciting. That said, let's get out on the track, do a little test lap, so I can show you what it's like to go around here. Want to stay on the apron. Guys are doing their hot laps, don't want to interfere with them. Now everything is realistic, the way the car handles. You can feel every little feedback in the wheel.
Gonna let this guy get in front of me. You're clear. You're still clear.
And I'm gonna floor it. Getting a nice exit out of turn 4. Through the dog leg here. Now I like to enter low. Wait to go over the bump. There it is. Get back on the power. Steer out to the wall. Turn 4, I like to lift for just a second. And then back on. The car will slide up the track because I'm really pushing it. But it will stick just fine. And we've gained. We've closed the gap to this car. I have a run on him. I would pass him probably by the back stretch. Yep, much faster than him. So I'm going to duck to the inside.
Outside on your tight there. Clear. One outside.
And if this is a race, I would have had the victory in the bag. And that's that. So that was warm up. You get a couple laps out, but we're going to grid up now. And I'm going to be quiet, I think, and let you guys enjoy it. I will obviously mention some things. That's the first time.
Good luck, guys.
I'll mute.
Pit road will still be closed here.
Turn down the driver chat a little bit because there is driver voice communications. Looks like that guy back there is running the Junior Time Warner paint scheme, which I have on my Sprint Cup car. It's my probably one of the nicest car Dale Jr.'s ever drove, but I'm not really a huge Junior fan. I do like him, he's just not my favorite driver, but that car is probably one of the sexiest cars I've ever seen. So we got a lot of cars here, and there might be some mayhem early, and it's probably going to be wrecks, but looks like these guys are all high-class drivers with high I ratings, and they look to be mostly A license or B, which is required to get in here. It starts off at rookie, then D, then C, then B, then A. So we're going to get rolling here on a pace lap, one lap. Usually get a hold around 60 miles an hour. Put it in third, look for the green lights. and that means I'm at pace speed. I'm going to have to go a little quicker just to get up to these guys.
All right, we're gonna
so if you're watching this and you want to know how to pace and you're new to iRacing, try not to use your brakes if you don't need to. Just let the car coast and make sure those green lights are on. You want to pace in third gear at most tracks and start in second at most tracks.
All right,
but if that tack is green, it tells you that you're at pace speed. Now, it won't be green in second gear because your miles, your speed will be different. But at third gear, at 3,500 RPMs, we are doing around 58, 60 miles an hour, which is what the pace car is doing. So I'm going to get focused here and get ready to go green. It's like that guy's rocking a monster car. It's very nice, actually. I like that car. So I'm going to downshift the second and get ready. I could start in first,
but
you see how high the RPMs are.
No pressure at all.
I would have to shift way soon. As soon as I got on the gas, I would have to shift, then I would lose time, so.
All right, pace car is in.
Looks like they jumped the start, which is fine.
Bring, everything's rolling, everything's rolling. Outside, door, still there.
Can hold
still
it
there.
Flat out through
still
here.
Still there. Still there, door. Here we go, man. Still outside. Alright, we are in the middle. Outside, two wide there. Still outside.
Guy was trying to force it three wide and I wasn't having
bumper,
any of it.
Bumper. Still there. Still just one outside, middle of the track. Just one outside, middle of the track. All clear.
Now to work on these guys. I lose a lot of time because I hit the apron.
Very good, that man. You had to sit up for a couple of days, not bad.
The Nationwide car is a lot easier to drive than it used to be. They made the car more tight. Not tight, it's just neutral. It used to get very loose. Looks like somebody got in the wall up there.
Holy crap,
check out. I'm gonna get ready to go to the bottom. Big group of guys up here really don't like where I am right now. I'm gonna have to ride this out because there's no speed in the high line. But I am gonna get slowed way down.
One outside. All clear. There's one inside down there on the line. Clear low. Just one inside laying off the bottom. Door still down there. Still there.
He's gonna get the pass fair and square.
Still one inside down there. Clear by two. On the line down there by himself.
Hitting the wall.
Still inside. One
didn't affect
inside.
Our car any, but
just one inside.
Got tight following that car.
Clear. All clear. Inside. Still there.
Yeah, we're falling back. Still as soon as you get forward. Caught on the high line here, it's it.
Bumper.
So I'm going to get
bumper.
On the brakes and let this guy by.
You're clear.
I know the tires are starting to fade. So I almost hit the apron there. Thanks for the nudge. Thanks for that nudge.
One inside on the bottom. One inside on the bottom. Still there. Clear, clear, clear.
Ignition.
I purposely crowded that guy. I didn't want to give him any room. Looks like there might be a wreck here. Car hit the wall into it, doored another car. So we want to take advantage of that, but at the same time, situational awareness is key. I'm looking ahead, far ahead as I possibly can. Hit the apron, I lost a lot of time there.
One inside, clear low, clear low.
Come on, let me down. Thank you. Try to suck up to this guy.
One inside, you're clear.
Now I have the power out on the high side.
One inside on the bottom, one inside all the way on the line there. Still there on the line.
You're gonna dive on the knee again, buddy.
Still inside, one inside.
Don't bump me on the straight.
Still one inside there. English please.
Okay.
All clear, all clear.
I don't speak Steve Irwin.
Haha! God, it's a checkup vest right here.
Outside, outside. All the way by the wall there. There you go, man. Still outside. Barely at your bumper. I can tighten. Still outside. Just one outside there. Just do your thing here. No pressure. Real tight in front of you there. Bumper to bumper. You're clear. You're clear.
Sorry, I didn't speak redneck.
Oh, I'm a stingray, bitch.
Settle down, ladies. To get a run off the corner. Yes, I am. Not a big enough one.
One outside. Just one outside. Still there, middle of the tank.
Sorry guys, I'm kind of being held up.
I think there's a crocodile on the infield there, Steve Irwin.
it down, back it down.
Wreck on the back, wreck on the back.
Caution it down.
Holy shit, that car is now a space shuttle.
Wow.
Hey man, do you have any idea what the water temperature is or what is it right now?
Oh my god. Alright guys, I will see you at the other end of this caution. I hope you guys found that entertaining. That was pretty tight racing. See you in a bit.
Pick up his car too.
Alright guys, welcome back. One to green. So, next time we come off turn four, we are going green and we will be back to racing. Everybody pit. The leaders did pit. Don't need fuel, but it took four tires. I think most people did. Somebody might have taken two. If they did, they're going to find out very soon within a couple laps that it's not going to be fast enough to keep up. The guys with four tires are going to fly right past them. I was already pretty damn quick on old tires. All you got to do is adjust your lift point and your turn in entry, your corner entry, basically. So
right,
if you back it up
here
a little bit more, you can still power up the corner and get a good run down the straight, even with old tires. So
I have in mind.
Here we go.
All right, eight cars in. Green or green? Rolling good, rolling good. Shouldn't be any checking up. Keep digging. One outside, one outside. Still there, still there, still there. You're all clear, you're all clear.
Messing up these corners. I can drive a lot better in this. Another one in the wall. There we go, much better at time, 2, 3, 4. Just gotta burp the throttle a little bit. Yeah, we're quick. Look at the gap we put behind us, the cars behind us. Now I'm on it all the way. I don't think we're done as far as cautions either. Got 20 laps to go.
20
to
go, man.
These guys are gonna get racing hard. I'm gonna close the gap. See if we can get a top five. That guy's almost in the wall. I gotta run one in the grass. Hang on to it.
Enter your door down there.
Car was jumping all over the place. Please.
Clear, clear, clear.
Now I put it in the wall because I was scared of him.
Oh.
Car's still driving all right. No, it's not. It sort of is. Camber's out of whack though. Yeah, there's no way I'm gonna keep up with them. Go by, I got camber damage.
One inside. Still there. You're clear.
Stren, huh? I use that fishing line. Good choice. Maybe if I just take my corners a little bit differently, it would be alright. Yeah, I think we'll be okay. I think we can catch this car in front of us and take back 8th place, but I don't think we'll do any better. As long as I keep it off the wall again. I should have lifted when I got forced high through the dog leg. That's not the line you take through there. But I have a lot more understeer now from what happened to the car. You can see how much I'm having to turn the wheel. Yeah, they're catching me. Very hard through there. Get me?
One inside down there on the line. Bumper. All clear.
If only we can get another car. Caution, yes!
What the fuck? Got a wreck in the one here. Keep coming.
Perfect. I was begging for that caution. Sorry.
Run some long gears.
I don't think there's any alligators down there.
What happened? I don't know. The new car about to lose its hooked apron a little bit. And they wrecked
it. What's with this Steve Irwin shit?
Alright. Not open yet, Stevie, from what I can tell.
Steve Irwin's the guy from Australia.
Yeah, not open yet. Do not pit.
Thinks this ain't funny. He's a fucking idiot.
On that 14.
You know what I think is a fucking idiot? You.
Alright, well guys, that's caution number 2, so I will see you when we're about to go green flag racing. Chances are I will be pitting, I will be taking 4 tires and getting some damage fixed if I have any. I don't think it's going to take that long. It was just a wall banger, but we'll see you on the other side when we're about to go green.
Why are you making Steve Irwin jokes? Dude, he's dead.
Alright guys, we're back. It's 1 to go.
1 to go already. Right here.
Fortunately, ran into some issues. I had 40 seconds of optional damage I had to fix. Otherwise, that just wouldn't have been competitive. So we're pretty much all the way back here. So it's going to be a shootout. It's going to be about a 9-lap shootout, 8-lap shootout by the time we go green. And I got 4 fresh tires. The damage is fixed, and I'm going to be hauling the mail. I'm going to see how many cars I can pass. I know I came in 10th, I believe. I was 10th. I'm down to 15th now. But I know I was faster than a lot of the cars up front when I hit the wall. And I was getting held up by that 4 car, the lowest car, pretty badly. Could not get around him any which way, and he was slow into the corners and slow out.
I put cover to the green.
So I left about 7 seconds of optional repair damage. I don't think it's going to make any difference, but we'll see what happens. Hopefully we don't get
the car, is it?
We don't get involved
green,
here.
Green, 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 everything's rolling good, plenty of the rolling good, rolling just fine.
Gonna get a run on this P car right now. Get him out of the way.
Outside of the door. Still outside, still outside there. Outside still. Clear high, clear high, clear high.
Still got a little bit of understeer issue, but we made up a spot, made up two spots actually. It's all about where you are in the track when you hit that bump. If you're too high, if you're too high on the track, you just lose time.
You're doing great, buddy. Five to go.
As soon as I hop over it, I floor it. He's gonna put a block on me.
Inside.
Fine.
Inside, clear.
Now I'm going to power it.
Still outside, outside. Still there, middle of the track. Still outside there, still outside. Clear.
And make the pass. See if we can gain a couple more, at least get back to where we were. Woo! I thought I was gonna nick that wall, but we took that corner as fast as it allowed us to. I'm just full throttle. Right front is screaming at me. Right front tire, I mean.
Two to go right here. Two
we only got a couple to go, and mayhem is not over yet. I'm going to follow these guys down low.
One outside. Still there. Clear.
Okay, can we pass one more car? Can we do it? I don't know.
There you go. One inside on the bottom. One inside on the bottom. Stay high, stay high, stay high, stay high. All clear.
Sorry about that, man. I went time there.
Oh, I'm gonna have a run! It's not gonna be enough! But we do finish 10th. 9th even, so we're in the top 10. Not bad. Not bad. Not what we wanted, but again, that damage I got did not help us. If we didn't have that damage, we would have been in the top 5. I would have taken 2 tires, and I probably would have been able to hold them off.
I'm so proud of you, man.
So, good stuff. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did and you want to see more iRacing stuff, at least on the oval side, I haven't put a lot of effort into the road stuff. I will eventually. You know, if you want to see more of this NASCAR type racing, whether it's the trucks or it's a sprint car or sprint cup car or the nationwide car, you know, just let me know. Leave a comment and I will put more videos up. I plan on doing some of the live streaming stuff. As far as my league races go. Until then, guys, have a good one, be safe, and see you in the next one. Peace.